Today, I am going to discuss the topic that is micro, small, and medium enterprise. Now, first of all, we are going to discuss the meaning of what is micro enterprise. So, there are two words, that is micro, and second one is enterprise. So, micro means the organization which do its operation on small scale basis. So, the term micro enterprise is also known as micro business. It refers to as the small business that employs few people. It is a sort of organization where number of workers are play their role in small scale. Only few workers are employed within the organization for accomplish their goals and operating their activities. If you are talking about the micro enterprise, they usually operate with the fewer than 10 people who are working within the organization. If you are talking about the number of workers who are performing their job within the organization, these organizations play their operations on very small scale, on very micro scale, in which number of workers, that is 10 number of workers, are performing their activities. And it started with this small amount of capital that is advanced from the bank or other organization. So for starting up or for establishment of these micro enterprises, the small amount of capital is also required to operate its operations, because finance is the lifeblood for any organization. Basically, they take the particular amount of finance in the form of loan from bank or any other financial institution. They help to start up their business in an effective way. So most of the enterprises are specialized in providing those number of goods and services for their local areas. Basically, these enterprises are set up for the purpose of establishment of rural areas, local areas, and for providing the number of goods and services that are specialized in service quality. Like, they help to increase the standard of living among the various people. So these business serves a vital purpose in improving the quality of life for the people in developing countries. If you are talking about the concept of developing countries, so basically the micro enterprises business helps and provide a vital variety of improvement services for improving the standard of living and quality of life among the people. And they also generally provide those products and services which are in their communities. Like, they find out what is the need and want of the general customer, what is the perception toward the general customer regarding the products and services. So after identifying the basic needs, basic quality, and how much amount they are willing to pay, then micro enterprises produce certain kinds of goods and services to satisfy the want of local area communities. So micro enterprises not only help to improve the quality of the business owner, but it also add the value among the local economy. More and more goods and services are produced by micro enterprises. They help the business owner to increase the quality of life. How? Because their goals are achieved. What plans and what decisions are decided by the organization before starting up the firm, those goals and activities are achieved according to the prescribed period of time. So micro enterprises help to increase the quality of life on the basis of business owners, as well as it also add the value to the local economy sector, in which the purchasing power of the consumer is increasing day by day, and it helps to increase their standard of living. Basically, the micro enterprises help the economy to increase the purchasing power because of the low quality, low cost, because of the low cost of products that are produced within the organization. It basically helps to improve the income and provide various job opportunities among the workers. Next one is the medium enterprise. Medium enterprise engaged in the manufacturing or production, processing or preservation of goods as specified below. Basically, the word enterprise itself means that where the goods and services are produced, how the goods and services are produced while adapting the procedure of production process, manufacturing process, and after the production process, these goods and services are delivered to the prescribed consumers as they are known by the enterprise. So the medium enterprise is an enterprise where the investment in plant and machinery is more than 5 crore. If you are talking about the investment procedure that is accomplished by the medium enterprise, these enterprise make various kinds of investments in plant and machinery for the purpose of production. And those investment is more than 5 crore, but doesn't increase rupees 10 crore. So here is the some criteria that is based on investment in plant and machinery equipments and annual turnover of micro, small and medium enterprise. If you are talking about the classification procedure, classification is depend upon the manufacturing of the enterprise and enterprise rendering the various kinds of services. If you are talking about the concept of micro enterprise, under micro enterprise, investment in plant and machinery or any kind of equipment that is used for the production process is not more than 1 crore. And the annual turnover of micro enterprise is not more than 5 crore. And if you are talking about the small enterprise involves the investment in plant and machinery or any kind of equipment that is used for the processing of raw material into finished product is not more than rupees 10 crore. And the annual turnover of small enterprises is not more than 50 crore. And the next concept is the medium enterprise. Medium enterprise involves the investment in plant and machinery or equipment that is not more than 50 crore. And the annual turnover that is involved in medium enterprise is not more than 250. The next concept we are going to discuss is characteristics of MSME enterprises. So the very first concept and characteristic we are going to discuss is micro, small and medium enterprises basically work for the welfare of workers and artisans. They help them to giving the employment opportunities by providing the loans and other services. So while the manufacturing of MSME enterprises, finance is required. They get the proper amount of finance and set a proper amount of budget that is provided by the banks. Bank provide loans and various kinds of services to the number of customers. By having the proper amount of finance within the organization, it helps the workers to improve their welfare as well as the production activities within the organization. So, with the help of proper amount of finance within the organization, it helps to promote and development of entrepreneurship as well as the upgradation of the skills by launching the specialized training centers for the same. If any entrepreneur who wants to set his or her own business in a market and want to establish the position within the market. Basically, these MSME guidelines provides the upgradation facility and number of skills to these kind of entrepreneurs so that they can retain a proper position within the market. According to the third point, they support the upgrading of development technology. The number of techniques, the number of plant and machinery and the infrastructure, all these facilities are up-to-dated and upgraded facilities are provided for the establishment of the enterprise. Basically, the infrastructure development and the modernization of this sector will also take care about while establishing these MSME enterprises. So MSME is also known to provide the reasonable assistance for improved assessment to domestic as well as the export market. So whenever the number of goods and services are produced or a proper units of production is produced within the market, these provide the reasonable assistance, means a reasonable cost is set for the number of customers who want to take these goods and services and satisfy their needs. It helps for the domestic development as well as these industries also provide some export facilities to the market that are being known as export markets. So they are also offer the modern testing facility and the quality certification services. Whatever the production is done, whatever the number of units are produced by MSME enterprises, all these goods and services must be in a good quality so that the customer will retain and buy product again and again. So these are the recent trends that is followed by the MSME for the development of economy. Basically, they help to support the product development, how the product is developed, how new features will be added in the existing product for the development of the existing product. Basically, they also provide the facility to design the particular innovative ideas, intervention, and packaging. All these factors must also be considered while producing the goods and services. The next concept we are going to discuss, that is the role of MSMEs in developing countries. If proper employment opportunities provided to the workers and cost-effective units are produced by the market, produced by the workers for the establishment of the number of goods and services to sell these kind of products within the market. So what is the basic role that is played by the MSME for developing countries? The very first one, since its formation, the MSME segment has proven to be the highly dynamic Indian economy sector, where the goods and services are produced according to the consent of consumer, according to the search of market, and after segmentation of market, then particular goods and units will be sold and distributed in that economic sector. So MSME produce and manufacture a number of variety of products. Those variety of products are produced for both domestic, that is used within the economy, as well as the international market, that is for the export purpose. Role of MSME also plays a very huge role within the development of economy because they help to promote and they promote the growth and development of khadi village and coal industries. Basically, these industries are formed in the backward sectors of the economy, and after the development of these type of economies, number of employment opportunities are provided to the unemployment people. It helps to promote the growth and help to grow the development of the khadi and village and various development to the coal industries. MSME also helped to collaborate and work with the concerned ministers, state government, stakeholders toward the upgrading of the rural areas. Basically, there is some collaboration with the number of ministers, state government, stakeholders. For what purpose of collaboration is done? These collaborations are done for the upgrading of the rural areas. Basic guidelines are formed by the state government, stakeholders, for the purpose of upgradation of these rural areas. So MSME have played an essential role in providing the employment opportunities in the rural areas. While established various kinds of industries in the rural areas, most of the unemployed people get employment opportunities in these enterprises, and it helps to raise the standard of living and satisfy their basic needs. According to the next point, they have helped in the industrialization of these areas with a low capital cost compared to the large areas. So while establishing, while starting up of these MSME enterprises, a very low cost of capital is required, and these funds can be get from the financial institution or banks in the form of loan. If we compare to the large industry's cost of capital, the cost of capital for MSME is quite low capital cost as compared to the large industries. So it also acts as the complementary unit of the large sector. where the establishment of large sector is not possible and the services provided by the large sector to the rural area is not possible, these MSME act as the complementary units for those large sectors. Because the MSME center has enormously contributed to the socio-economic development. These economy are set to that backward areas, rural areas, and provide efficient amount of services to the number of customers. So these enterprises also contribute and play a major essential role for what purpose? For the development of countries in different areas where the requirement is necessary. Like what kind of requirement is needed for the establishment of MSME, that is low cap investment, flexibility in operations. Flexibility in operations mean whenever the circumstances of the external environment is changed, that is increasing amount of raw material or decreasing amount of raw material. All these operations are flexible in nature. After considering all these things, that is the contribution. What kind of a contribution is contributed by the MSME for the development of economic development? So according to the next point, that is mobility through the location, low rate of imports, and high contribution to the domestic production. Mobility through the location, that wherever the goods are necessary, wherever the production is necessary, they can move from one place to another and provide services to those sectors easily. So the import rates, what kind of import rates? That is the demand of raw material from the another place is quite low as compared to the large industries. So they help in contributing at the higher scale to the domestic production sectors. The next topic we are going to discuss is the advantages of MSM enterprise. The very first point is MSMEs enable citizens of the nation to venture out on their own and in turn give back to the society. How they give back to the society? By providing the various new job opportunities and diversifying in an area gross domestic production. So if number of entrepreneurs who want to set up their own venture, own business, they can go through the MSME enterprise, which in turn provide the various kind of new job opportunities and providing various new employment opportunities to the unemployed workers, and it helps in diversifying the amount of gross domestic production in an economy. So they also slow and steady revive an artisans class in the far reaches of India by providing opportunities and access to loan and other services to the said class. Whenever an entrepreneur want to set up their own venture, what they need? They basically need the amount of loan from the financial institution. So the proper amount of loan in with the very low amount of interest is provided to these sectors. So step by step, these enterprises, that is MSM enterprises, can run their business and providing employment opportunities and providing various kind of services to the number of sectors. So furthermore, they constantly support up the upgradation of technology, infrastructure development, and trigger the modernization of the country and our society as a whole. If these enterprises are set up in those areas where the employment opportunities are must, these setup of MSM enterprises helps in upgrading the technology because new innovative ideas are used for the process of production. So while upgrading the new techniques, infrastructure development is also increased, and it helps to figure out the modernization of the society as a whole. If a part of the economy, that is a backward area, is increasing day by day, then it helps in modernizing the country slow by slow and day by day as a whole. If you're talking about the next concept, that is the overdraft interest rate exemption. If any venture or any entrepreneur want to have some amount of loan from the bank, the overdraft facility is also provided by the bank to the number of entrepreneurs. So business and enterprises registered as MSME can avail the benefit of 1% on the overdraft in the scheme of the different bank to bank. Whenever the enterprise want to have some financial amount from the bank, if that enterprise or entrepreneur is registered under MSME enterprise guideline, then definitely they get some facility regarding the benefit of 1% amount on which, that is overdraft facility scheme, that is provided by different banks, and according to different banks, these interest rate will vary. So this helps to make the small business secure during the unfavorable markets. Whenever the market conditions are unfavorable and due to changing in income of the consumer and due to changes in the customer's need, customer perception and customer taste, the conditions are unfavorable for the number of enterprises. Over that period of time, the overdraft facility regarding the finance will be provided by different banks. And these enterprises can avail the benefit of 1% interest on overdraft facility. The next one is the fuel electricity bills. All these companies that have to MSME registration certificate, that is micro, small and medium enterprise according to guidelines, they are registered and get the certificate that they can run their business. These are entitled and get some amount of concession on their electric bill. Whatever the goods and services are produced and the plant and machinery is used for running the plant and machinery and for performing the various kind of operations, the electricity bill and the amount of electricity bill will be concessed by the MSME guidelines. So this enables the business to boost up the production, because these enterprises mainly focus on the boost of the production, except that how they can pay the electricity bill and take in more order without worrying about the capital expenditure on the costs like electricity and maintenance. As I have already said, most of the enterprises who are producing the goods and services and convert these goods and services by having the amount of raw material, and by using that raw material, that how they can convert these raw material into the finished goods. All these processes required a proper cycle, and to perform these operations, electricity is required. Basically, pure electricity bill and concession on the electricity bill will definitely provide some relief to these sectors, that they are not worrying about the amount of capital, that how they can pay the particular amount of bill on the production process. So there is nothing to worry about the capital expenditure on cost, that is electricity and any kind of maintenance charges. So if you are talking about the concept that is in India, the MSME contribute nearly about 8% of the country's GDP. By selling the variety of goods, how much they contribute? They mainly contribute about 8% on GDP and around 45% of the manufacturing output. How much they manufacture the goods and services? While having a variety of raw material and with use of that raw material, the output they produce is around 45%. And approximately with the manufacturing of this output amount of number of units, they can approximately 40% of the country's export process is performed by these MSME enterprises. So while having a view about the amount of GDP, the amount of manufacturing output, and the amount of country's export, we can say that it is the backbone of the country for the development sector. The government of India has introduced the MSME, or we can say micro, small and medium enterprises, in the agreement with Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Development Act 2006. With the establishment of various guidelines and while performing these guidelines, micro, small and medium enterprises can run their business with the registration process and having a certificate that is provided by Government of India. And this act is come under the Act of 2006. That is, the establishment of this act is 2006. The next concept we are going to discuss is the role of MSME in developing countries, that how they can play a role in the developing countries. So these enterprises preliminarily engaged in the production, manufacturing, processing, preservation of goods and commodities. Basically, the major role that is performed by the micro, small and medium enterprises is the production. That how they can produce the number of goods and services while keeping in view the consent of the customers, keeping in view about the market segmentation. And after doing the production and manufacturing process, how the further process is accomplished, that is the distribution of goods and commodities among the number of customers. MSME are an important sector for the Indian economy and have the contributed immensely to the countries like socio-economic development. If we are connected with this first point, that is production, manufacturing and processing, all these steps are performed by MSME enterprises. So these enterprises also play an important role for the Indian economic sector too, because they help in contributing the efficient amount in the sector of socio-economic development. So it is not only generated for the purpose of employment opportunities, but it also works hand in hand toward the development of the nation of backward sectors as well as the rural sector. How the development process is accomplished? That is, a proper amount, that is cost efficient amount of goods and services are provided to the customers. Customers are satisfied, they are willing to pay the particular amount. It will help to create the GDP and increase the GDP. While increasing all these factors, it helps to development of economy day by day. MSME produced and manufactured a variety of products. What kind of products are produced and for what they are produced? They produce goods for domestic as well as international market too. So they help and promote the growth of the development like khadi and other villages and core industries. What kind of goods and services they are produced like khadi and villages for what? For what areas like villages and core industries, these goods and services and employment opportunities are provided for the purpose of development. So they are collaborative and workers are concerned like ministers, state government, stakeholders toward the upbringing of the rural areas. While having the collaboration with the ministers who provide the guidelines, for what purpose? That how they can upgrade the rural areas and provide more facilities to these areas. So these industries basically help in providing the employment opportunities in rural areas.